Hi guys, my name is Michael. In this video created by my friend Tyler Just Fly, he's gonna show you how you can install Tamux on your Android phone from Play Store and how you can set it up and use it to upload your file to GitHub. First, I'm gonna give you some few intros or some of the command he's going to use, and after that, Tyler, take over. These are some of the code you're going to use after you're done installing the Tamux into your Android phone from Play Store. First, you need to type in PKG upgrade, then press enter. Once you are done, you need to install GitHub to your phone. After installing GitHub into your phone, you can use ls. LS allows you to view files in your phone. CD allows you to move around in your directory. So depending which folder you want to open, you just need to type CD, then the name of the folder. So it could be storage or Android, anywhere you've stored your files. Just put CD, then the name of the file. Then if you want to make a folder, simply type mkdir, then the name of the folder. So the name of the folder could be side also, it could be any other name you want. If you want to clear your code, just type in clear. To create a file, if you want to create a file like your index or your CSS file, you just need to type touch, then the name of the file plus the extension. It could be style.css or style.javascript or index.html. I do advise you to use index.html for your HTML file, and also make it small letters. Don't make the first letter a capital letter, make all of them small at once. So it could be index.html. After you have done creating your folder and your file, and you have started with your code, and you're done with coding, and you now want to push it to the staging area, this is the things you need to do. First, you need to have a GitHub account. If you already have a GitHub account, you should log in. After logging in, you should create a repository. We're going to show you how to create a repository, and I'm going to put a link in my description showing you how to create an account on GitHub. So after you're done doing that, you come back to the Tamux command line, then you type git init to initialize your project. After that, you can view the status to know if it has been committed or not by typing in git status, so that you can add all your project to the staging area at once. You can either type git add, then a space, then a full stop, or you can add it one by one if you want. You can just put git add, then the name of the project. It could be index.html or index.js. After that, you can commit your project by typing in git commit dash m. Then you have to put a commit message. So your commit message could be just telling like a short description, like this is my first commit, or you can just put the name of the project there. It could be basically anything, any text you can type in it, but you have to put it in a quotation mark, double quotation mark, then you put in your message in it. So just goes git commit dash m, double quotation mark opening, then your message, then double quotation mark closing. Then after that, you need to log into your GitHub using this command git config dash global space user dot name. Then you put in your GitHub username. Once you're done putting your GitHub username in the double quotation mark, You also need to put in your email address that is linked to your GitHub account. So just put in your gitconfig global user.email. You put in your email address in between the double quotation mark. So the last step after you're done staging your process is to push it to the GitHub server. Now, all you need to do is, once you create your repository, you see a couple of code. You see, the first one is for if you want to create the repository using the command line, or the second one is also if you want to push to the repository through the command line. We're going to use the second code, and this is likely what you're going to see there: git remote add original. Then you're going to see a link. Copy that into your Tamax command line. Then you can view the branch you're pushing it to. Then you type git push. That is to push it to the GitHub server. So you just type git push minus u original master. So you're going to put in your GitHub username and your password. And once you have done with that, the project would have been pushed to GitHub. Then you can now go to your GitHub online and refresh. Once you are done, you'll see your project there. These are some of the codes you're going to use in your Tamax command line.
Hi guys, my name is Tyler Joshua, and I'll teach you guys how to push your code to GitHub using your mobile device. So you can do this by installing Tamax. You can do this with the Tamax terminal. So you install your Tamax in Google Play and then you click open. I have mine installed and I have my. So we are going to be using Git. So first of all, we have to install Git. Install pkg install Git. So it's installing. I have mine installed anyway, so it's just going to tell me. Okay, why is it slow? Why is it slow today? No, it's a byte. Okay, what's happening now? Okay, so Git is already the newest version, so I already have the new version. So let's navigate to the folder that will be keeping our file. So ls is for list, to check the folders that you're going to be changing your directory to. So cd means change directory, so change directory storage. We are changing the directory to storage ls. So I've changed my directory to shared ls. I'm changing my directory to Android, to an Android folder. So this Android is where I keep most all of my code. So let's create a folder for this tutorial. So to create a folder, you type make directory side also. Okay, so change directory side also. We are going into the folder. So we don't have any file there right now. So let me clear this up so we can have a clean terminal. So touch index dot html. Let me switch off my data to avoid messages coming in. So let's say touch index dot css. It's the sessions. So we already have my index dot html and css file. Now let's put something in them. So I use a code. I don't know, you can use any text editor you want. I just love this because it helps me easily . So this is the folder I'll be writing to. So it gives me So I put my link CSS index.css. So this is what I meant. It's going to bring it out for me. And so I'm going to type h1. See, I just love it. Like, I don't like stress, so so let's say hello world. So let me start my hello world tag. Sure. Color red. So let's try that out if it works. Okay, it works. So let's push it to our GitHub, to our Git. So first of all, you need to let's create our GitHub repository. Let's create our GitHub repository. Okay, my GitHub loading. Switch up. Create a new repository. So let's name it Side Awesome. Side Awesome is available. So don't tick all these ones, because if you tick it, it's going to throw an error. And why it's going to try another is because your local repository does not match with the online repository, so it's going to try another if you are trying to push, unless you pull before you push. But we can create our README, we can create our README file from our local repository too. So let's say touch README. .md. So let's put something in our readme.md file too. Can you type in now? To get up with you. Device. Okay. So let's initialize Git with Git init. So initialize empty Git repository. So I have my Git in it. So my Git has been initialized. So let's type Git status. Git status is used to check the files that you have not committed to the staging area. So if you want to commit these files to the staging area, you can commit them one by one by using git add git add the name of the file index.css. So if you type git status, you see index.css has been added to the staging area. But me, I don't like CSS, so I just love adding everything at once. So I type git add all, so I add everything at once. So let's check our git status now. It has been added, so let's commit these files. Git commit slash adding some files. So also let's add our username to GitHub. Git config. So you can add your username in git config. Git config global user dot name. So okay, it worked. So git config, we are adding our username to now. Git, we're adding our email to now. Git config global user dot email. So I let just fly. Why it's not bringing it. So I just fly one dot gmail dot com. Okay, so now that we have committed everything, let's push it to our online repository. So to push our online repository, copy this. And then you should paste it remote. So it worked, it didn't give us any error. So you have to, before you push, you have to be mindful of the name of the branch you are pushing to. Sometimes it might be main, sometimes it might be master. So if you mistakenly type git push main instead of master, is going to throw an error. So for you to be sure, you can just type git branch to check. So the branch that we are pushing to is master. So you can say git push origin master. So it's going to ask me for my username and password. So my username is just fly, and then my password is okay. It's pushing. So finally, it's pushed it. So that's it. So reload this, and then. It's there, so you can see readme file. This is a tutorial to push codes to GitHub with a mobile device. Readme. Okay, so that's just basically it. It's not that difficult. So thank you guys for watching.